بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا، وبعد. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. رب أودعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه، وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين. To my dear brothers and sisters, an important subject discussed every year at this time, coming to the end of the year in the month of December. A lot of Muslims debate whether the celebration of the new year, as it is a custom all over the world, in New Year's Eve, where people celebrate the coming of the new year, is something that we could rejoice in or not. And the confusion comes because a lot of people, unfortunately, confuse the celebration with Eid. And many try to fix Muslim celebrations in just the two Eids, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. That is true when it comes to celebrating the ending of two important acts of worship. The first being the end of the fasting of the month of Ramadan, and to begin the month of Shawwal, it becomes a celebration that is ordained by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Eid al-Fitr. And it's not just one day, it is 3 days. The first, the second, and the third of Shawwal, in which Muslims are to rejoice by showing gratitude and going to the plains, and in our case, into our masajid, to pray behind the imam. 2 rak'ahs of salah, salatul Eid, with a difference of takbir after the opening takbir of the salah. In the first rak'ah, and after the takbir when you stand up for the second rak'ah. In Abu Hanifa's teaching, 3 takbirs in the first and the second, and in some teaching 5 and 3, but in Imam Malik teaching it is an Ahmad, Ibn Hanbal and Shafi'i, 7 and then 5. It doesn't matter. It is a way of recognizing the importance of the bounty that we have received from Allah by giving us the tawfiq or the success to be able to fast for a month to achieve piety as Allah prescribed. The second Eid, Eid al-Adha, when the Muslims stand on the day of Arafah. And Arafah is Hajj. If you miss Arafah, you miss Hajj. So standing the day of Arafah, or standing on Arafah on the day of the 9th of Dhul Hajjah, or a part of the day before sunset, that is a great, magnificent opportunity for a person who's trying to relinquish his longing for this world and hold on to his hopes for the hereafter with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, Al-Hajj Arafah. Hajj is Arafah. So on the 10th of Dhul Hajjah, in a way of sacrificing to show gratitude, we sacrifice a sheep or a bull or whatever we can find to sacrifice for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is guarded by rules and regulation according to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So these are the two Eids that ordained for a spiritual reason. But yet celebrations in Islam are encouraged, such as the declaration of the nikah, the walima, the coming of a child by doing the aqiqah, and even when the boy that's circumcised, and many other occasions in the life of the human that need to be celebrated. When you succeed in anything, you can celebrate, and celebration is to show joy by sharing your celebration with others in feeding them. Nothing wrong with that. That is fine. So in this false other celebration, like the coming of the new year, some of the Muslims are so rigid in that the calendar is only one calendar, and it is the lunar calendar, as it is mentioned in the Quran, in Surah At-Tawbah, verse 36. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا. The number of months in the sight of Allah are 12. إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا. في كتاب الله يوم خلق السماوات والأرض. In the book of Allah, the preserved tablet, the day he created the heaven and the earth. منها أربعة حرم, from which there are four, which are special, holy or sacred month. Allah says, فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ Do not wrong yourself in these 4 months, which are prescribed by the Prophet as Rajab. And he called it Rajab Mudar. Mudar is a tribe that used to take a lot of heed in this month and do a lot of good activities. And then the three consecutive one, which is Dhul Qa'idah, the month before the end of the year, 11. And then number 12, Dhul Hajjah, and the beginning of the year, Muharram. So the 4 months, Rajab, Dhul Qa'idah, Dhul Hajjah, and Muharram. These months are special because there are significant things that has taken place, will take place in them. Allah ordered in them that way. He said, do not wrong yourself in this month. Indeed, all time is important because everything you do in your time, you'll be questioned about. But these 4 months, people take notice. Other than that, then the other months like Ramadan, which is also very important for fasting. It's not one of the four Allah mentioned in the Quran. Here, we need to understand as well, the calendar is not only measured by the moon. In fact, in the Holy Quran, if we go and look into Surah Yunus, and we look at verse number 5, Allah says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم هو الذي جعل الشمس ضياء. It is He, Allah the Almighty, who made the sun as a source of light. والقمر نورا. And the moon reflective of the light of the sun. وقدره منازل. And made the moon to grow from a crescent to full moon, and to come back to a crescent in stages. Manazil al-qamar, or the stages of the moon. Why? لتعلموا عدد السنين والحساب, so that you will be able to reckon or to count or to comprehend the number of years and arithmetic. ما خلق الله ذلك إلا بالحق. Allah did not create this only through the truth. يفصل الآيات لقوم يعلمون. Allah is clarifying the verses for people who have knowledge. إن في اختلاف الليل والنهار. Indeed, in the differing of the night and the day. وما خلق الله في السماوات والأرض. لآيات لقوم يتقون. And whatever Allah has created in the heavens or the earth are signs for people who are trying to achieve or acquire piety. People who avoid to do anything that Allah will not be happy with. From this verse or those two verses, we could recognize that It's not only the lunar calendar, but also the sun calendar can be utilized. Therefore, when we count from January to December, the calendar here is measured by the sun, which is longer by 10 days than the lunar calendar. The lunar calendar is shorter. And both are of the creation of Allah. Indeed, the lunar calendar, when Umar ibn al-Khattab was the Khalifa, and he was encouraged to create this calendar for the Muslims through the Islamic month that they are utilizing for their living and their worship, because they have seen the people in Sham, when they used to travel there, they're using other calendars. But the essence of the calendar is the same. 12 months and 52 weeks and 7 days in the week. No calendar have 13 months or 14 months. This is the way it is ordained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the reason for it, Allah says, so that you can begin to count time, measure it in a year time. Every 12 months makes 1 year. So here, I would like everybody listening not to bring Islam to disrepute and talk about things to belittle the magnificence of the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the wisdom of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in identifying for us what to do and what not to do. And I always say, a lot of the sunnah activity that we carry out in our life comes from the culture approved, because the sunnah components are the Prophet's acts, what he did, the Prophet's words, what he said, and the Prophet approvals. Most of the approvals are cultural things. As long as they do not contradict the Quran nor the Sunnah, it's lawful. Nothing wrong with it. For indeed, what is forbidden, what is haram, what is unlawful, is when Allah says it's haram, it's unlawful, or His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sharia, the laws, are put by Allah. And the one who carried out the Sharia and shown the way of how to carry it out in our life, al-Mushari' or al-Shari', is Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah says in the Quran, you should never say to something that is lawful, unlawful. For Allah alone and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have that right. We don't have that right. However, we say to people, when there are cultural things that do not contradict the Quran and the Sunnah, you can enjoy them in your life as long as they do not bring the forbidden. So one of the things that sometimes people see in the celebration of the coming of the new year, in the new year eve, people go out, get drunk, free mixing, doing the wrong things that are not allowed in Islam. Of course, you cannot make something lawful when there are activities which are unlawful in it. It doesn't make sense. But you should acknowledge. So my advice to everybody, and as I usually try to do, the year when it ends, let us say by the 31st of December, 1 year has passed. We need to account for what we have done in this 1 year. For Rasulullah sallam said, حَاسِبُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبُوا. Judge yourself before you are judged. So this is so important. So we reflect upon the past year at the end of December. And we ask Allah to forgive us for all the things that we have done wrong. And we ask Allah to accept every good we strive to do and to accept all our salah, all our fasting, because our actions are between being accepted or rejected. You can't say just I prayed or I fasted. Allah could accept it, Allah could reject it. So you need to be very careful and leave it to Allah. For only through His mercy, we can be successful. And when the new year begins, then we need to ask Allah to make it easier for the new year and to allow us to enter it with the entrance of truth. وَقُلْ رَبِّ أَدْخِنِّي مُدْخَلَ صَدْقٍ. The Prophet ﷺ was taught in Surah Al-Isra to pray this prayer. وَقُلْ رَبِّ and say, Oh my Lord, أَدْخِنِّي مُدْخَلَ صَدْقٍ. Allow me to enter the entrance of truth. وَأَخْرِجْنِي مُخْرَجَ صَدْقٍ and allow me to exit the exit of truth. وَاجْعَلْ لِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ سُلْطَانَ نَصِيرًا and make for me from your presence a strong support to guide me, to enlighten me, to support me, to help me. For indeed there is no power nor will only by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't see it, but in the book of the earlier generation among the sages and the scholars of Islam, such as Imam al-Haddad rahmatullah alayh of Yemen, they have the dua of the end of the year and they have the dua of the beginning of the year, in which they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive and to accept. Forgive the evil and accept the good. And ask Allah for the new year to bring goodness and to remove obstacle and evil from our path. So this is so important for everybody to take notice of. And before this pandemic, we used to meet and make dhikr in the night of the new year or the new year eve. And we start our dhikr, let us say about 11, half past 11, and then we go until about half past 12, so that we end the year remembering Allah and we exit. And inshallah, this year we'll be doing it, but through Zoom. Inshallah, if Allah allows us the same way, so that we can do the right thing, but yet not to shun what people are doing, because we are not bringing anything new. All these things started from the beginning when the human was allowed to exist on this earth. As Rasulullah said clearly, كلكم لآدم. You are all from Adam. وآدم من تراب, and Adam is from the dust. There is no preferences. As Rasulullah said in the hadith, لا فضل لعربين على عجمي. There is no higher standing for an Arab beside an Arab. ولا لأبيض على أسود. Nor for one who's white against the black person. All humans are the same in the sight of God. The only thing that differentiates between them is the goodness that they can generate in their existence on this earth. The better they are, the more closer to Allah they are, and the more recognized as good people in the sight of God. Other than that, evil is evil and goodness is goodness. Whether you are an Arab or an non-Arab, whether you are black or white, yellow or red, whatever, you doesn't matter. Allah doesn't look at your shapes and figures, cultures and languages and colors. No, Allah looks into your hearts and your deeds. As long as the deeds are good, Allah is pleased with the servant. So let us end this year, start from tonight until inshallah next Thursday evening by doing a lot of good and every day seeking forgiveness. Try to remember the thing that you went wrong with and ask Allah to forgive, and the goodness that you did, beg Allah to accept it from you. And when the new year begin, ask Allah for relief, ask Allah for openings, ask Allah for protection, ask Allah for making life easy, not just for you, and pray for everybody. I can't forget, I'm always insisting that don't pray just for yourself. It's good to pray for everyone. And it's even better by names, if you can remember. I always try to make it like a sunnah. When I do my dhikr, I pray for a lot of the people from the Prophet time. For the Prophet's wife, for the Prophet boys, for the Prophet daughters, okay? And for the generation of the Sahabas, and for the Tabi'een, for Tabi'at Tabi'een, for the sages. And those whom I can remember by name, I mention significantly, because all those whom you pray for, they will say Ameen. And the angel will say, what you ask for them, Allah is going to give you twice. Laka mithlayha. So, in dua, we should never be stingy. And all our brothers and sisters that we know who are in difficulty, we pray for them. Those who have passed away, we pray for them. We should remember them. What kind of people we will be if we don't remember our deceased, that whom we know? Especially those who used to be close to us. For example, for us in the circle, there are brothers like Dr. Khalid, Brother Fahim Madhari, his son As-Sadiq, Ahmed Nadir, Brother Bilal, and many others that can go on, Brother Qasim, Mustafa, all those people who are close to us, whether we like them or we don't like them, whether we were acquainted to them or not, we pray for them. May Allah forgive them. May Allah raise them. May Allah, in the day of judgment, elevate them. Only when you wish for your brothers and sisters what you love for yourself, then you can call yourself a believer. لا يؤمن أحدكم. None of you can say I'm a believer until you love for your brother or sister what you love for yourself. And finally, we try to relinquish any ill feelings, any bad feelings in our heart towards anybody. If we have enmity, animosity, anger, even if people were evil to us and we are upset with them, try to take that burden away from you. Say, oh Allah, for your sake, I'm forgiving. Be like the Prophet ﷺ when he entered Mecca and he said to the people of Mecca, اِذْهَبُوا فَأَنْتُمُ الطُّلَغَاءُ. Go, you are free. I forgive all of you. Even if you damaged my community and killed many of them and made many of them destitute and you robbed them, you took their tortured, whatever, I forgive you. Although conquerors always take revenge. Even in our time now, people are taken, imprisoned, tortured. The Prophet ﷺ, being the source of mercy, never did that. If we are truly his followers, and especially us who are reading the Dalail, the Salawat, and it's called Dalail al-Khairat. What a beautiful name. So you can't be hoping for khair for yourself, yet trying to keep it away from others. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. And we have not sent you, O Muhammad, only as a mercy to the world. If we are his, then we are a part of this mercy. May Allah forgive me and forgive you. May Allah grant me and grant you the success that we require and need. May Allah give us tawfiq. May Allah give us tawfiq. I pray that everyone listening and everyone will listen later from this recording, Allah will allow them to see the truth, to be able to stand upon the path of truth, and to strive to always be truthful in the path of truth. For Allah is the truth, and His Messenger is the truth. And the word of the Quran is true, and the wisdom of the Prophet ﷺ is the ultimate truth. May Allah remove all the calamities in the world. May Allah allow us to be lanterns through which people can see the truth. May Allah protect our families and give them tawfiq, our wives, our children, our parents, those who are alive. May Allah give them long life with obedience. Those who passed away, may Allah forgive them. Our relatives, our friends, and all the brothers and sisters who used to attend the circles and are long, longer here, those who passed away, may Allah forgive them, and those who are alive, may Allah keep them well and safe, inshallah. Anybody who have any difficulty in their life, may Allah remove it. Anyone who is sick, may Allah heal them. All those who are serving the sick, may Allah serve them. All those who are seeking work, may Allah provide for them. And all those who are striving to accomplish good on this earth, may Allah always be in their sight to do good. And we ask Allah for Rumi's cave in Carlton Center. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to be able to keep that building. And may Allah allow the council and its leaders to turn away from their planned activities for the place in the regeneration, Ya Kareem. May Allah make it forever a place whereby we can shout loudly the word of truth, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma inna nas'aluka bihaqqiha wa makanatiha wa uluwi qadriha wa jalalika ya jaleel, bismillahi jalla jalaluhu, huwa ar-Rahman ar-Rahim al-Hayy al-Qayyum al-Aliyy al-Azim, dhul jalal wal ikram rafi'a darajati dhil arsh, bihi atawassalu ilayka ya Rabbi, illa ma ja'alta man yaquduna hukmatana al-mahalliya an yughayyiru ra'yihim bima yajri ya Rabbana bihadha al-mabna. قالتم سنت يا رب اجعله لنا ولا تأخذه منا. أقسمت عليك بالنبيين والمرسلين والصالحين والصالحات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والأعمال التي بدت منهم بقدرتك من الطيبات إلا ما وفقتنا لذلك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلي اللهم على سيدنا محمد وآله وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. الفاتحة. لله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. جزاكم الله ألف خير. مصطفى السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام شيخ حبيبي.
الحمد لله. How are you keeping are you all right?
الحمد
لله. With your wife and the children.
الحمد لله.
And your in-laws, your parents, and your family generally. May Allah bless them for you. And may Allah give you a good ending for this year. And may Allah give you the best opening for the hereafter, inshallah. And I hope all those people who are listening, I can only just see your picture. I'm not seeing anybody else. May Allah bless all of them. May Allah give them tawfiq for dunya wal akhirah. And I say salam to all of them, inshallah. And we'll see you next week, inshallah. We are doing, I think, the New Year gathering on the Thursday evening, inshallah.
Inshallah.
We will meet there, inshallah, and we'll be together. So, assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.